Welcome to my new video. It will be regarding P-block elements. Actually, I didn't have the camera for a few days, so I didn't make the video. This video will be very, very, very helpful. That's my promise. So let me begin with some tips regarding this group. So first of all, you must have seen the questions where it must be written. NH4, NO2 on heating gives what gas? NH4, NO3 on heating gives what gas? NH4 whole twice Cr2O7 on heating gives what gas? Now what do we actually do here? We learn the gases, that this gives some gas, this gives some gas in the preparation of N2, N2O, etc. So let me tell you how to do these type of questions and how to remember. Whenever you see these type of questions, first of all, always remove H2O. Example, NH4, NO2, don't go by the gases, instead go by the water. How many H2O can you remove here? See, I can remove 2 H2O here. Maximum number of H2O you have to remove. So I can remove 2 H2O here, okay? So after removing H2O, what I'm left? N and N. So N2 gas will be released, okay? Now let me take example for the next one. When I take NH4, NO3, if I remove 2 H2O, you have to remove maximum number of H2O. See, this will be gone and this will remain N, N and O. Something like this will remain. So what you have to do? Plus, I get N2O. So this is the gas that is evolved, okay? Now next thing, NH4 whole twice Cr2O7 on heating gives what? Now first of all, write this as a simple compound. I can write this as NH4 whole twice Cr2O7 is ammonium dichromate. So I can write this as to be N2H8Cr2O7. Okay, so see, I have to remove the water molecules first of all. So how many water molecules maximum can be removed? You have to see first that thing. I can remove 4 H2O to the maximum amount. Okay, so further let's go. So if I remove 4 H2O, then N2Cr2O3, I am getting this thing on removing 4 H2O. So remove Cr2O3, and what is the gas left? N2. So nitrogen will be evolved. So this way we can learn about some of the important things in this chapter. So let's move further. So in NCERT it is given that BaN3 whole twice on heating gives 3N2 plus barium. NaN3 on heating gives Na plus, you can say actually 2 moles, so 2Na plus 3N2. So why this reaction is important? Because I am getting pure nitrogen here. This is pure, this is pure. So pure nitrogen. So this thing must be remembered, that these two are used for the generation of the pure nitrogen. Okay. So next thing. See, first of all, I would like to tell you that whenever I have HNO3, be it dilute or concentrated, I react with any metal, be it less reactive, more reactive or least reactive, then always one product will be MnO3. Let me take an example. If I take Cu plus HNO3 diluted or Cu plus HNO3 concentrated, one product will always be CuNO3 whole twice. So CuNO3 whole twice. Now let's go further on how to decide that which gas is released, okay? So I would take just three metals to prove that how to do that. If I have least reactive metals, which consists of like silver, gold, platinum, least reactive metals. Next are less reactive metals. So what are these types? Like Cu, you can say copper, and more reactive or the most reactive types like Zn, Na, etc. I am taking less examples because only these will be required. So what I want to teach here is, if I take the more reactive metals and I react with concentrated HNO3, I will not take concentrated HNO3 because I will tell you, any metal plus concentrated HNO3 means any type of metal that is less reactive, least reactive or more reactive. So I will always get NO2 as the product. Okay. So this thing is fixed, concentrated HNO3. So I will not be taking it again and again because NO2 will be evolved. That is fixed. So if I take more reactive metals along with dilute HNO3. Okay, dilute HNO3. So I will be getting NO gas. Actually N2O. This was the basic confusion. I also had it. So less reactive will be in dilute HNO3. It will always give NO gas. So combining whatever we have learned, let's combine it. So let me take a more reactive metal, that is Zn plus concentrated HNO3. So what is the product that I'll get? So let us fix it. So see, with concentrated HNO3 or any type of HNO3, what is the first thing that I have told you? That we'll get MnO3. So I'll get Zn NO3 whole twice on the basis of the valency. Second step, for the more reactive metal, for the more reactive metals like Zn and Na, I will be getting N2O. So the second step will be to release N2O plus some water. So actually I will take this to be the diluted HNO3. Now when I take to be concentrated HNO3, so what happens? First step is to release Zn NO3 whole twice. Second step will be with concentrated HNO3, always I will get NO2 to be one of the products. Okay, now what will be the third step to generate H2O? So this is the basic thing that we have to learn. Now I will tell you how to balance the equations by the mathematical method. Please watch it very carefully. See, these are, let me take a simple equation. Okay, so N2 plus H2 gives NH3. Okay, this is a basic equation that we know. So let me take this to be A, this to be B, this to be C. First of all, you have to balance the elements on both the sides. I repeat, elements, not compounds. So let us begin. So see, how many N are here? 2A. How many N are here? C. How many H are here? 2B. How many H are on the other side? 3C. So we have got two equations. So we are having three variables here actually. So what to do? Assume any one. Okay, let me assume C to be 1. You can assume 2, 3. These all are in ratios. So we will be getting equal values. So it's your wish how to assume it. So let me assume C to be 1. So A I will get as 1 by 2. And B I will get as 3 by 2. Okay, from the equations. So let me put here. So what is A? 1 by 2 N2. What is B? 3 by 2 H2. What is C? 1. So 1 NH3 multiply by 2 on both sides. So N2 plus 3 H2 will give me 2 NH3. So you can balance the equations like this by knowing the products. So why I have told you this? Because in the exams they will be asking you to write the balanced equation of Zn plus dilute HNO3. So what to do in those cases? Assume this to be A, this to be B, this to be C, D and E. So instead of learning the equations at home, we can directly derive the equations and put the coefficients for that. Because anytime an integer question can be asked, like 1 mole of Zn requires how much moles of concentrated HNO3, etc. or like that. So practice it once, and if there are any doubts, you can definitely ask me in the comment section. So thank you and best of luck.